Bitcoin uses ECDSA, or Elliptic Curve's digital signature algorithm, to produce private keys and public keys. An elliptic curve is just a mathematical curve defined by the general form y squared equals x cubed plus ax plus b. We take everything over a finite field because we want to encode every possible value in a constant amount of space. So here's a picture of Bitcoin's elliptic curve SECP256K1 on the right side. Its equation is y squared equals x cubed plus 7, and was engineered to have some unique properties that we'll be explaining in the coming slides. As mentioned earlier, it's taken over a finite field so as to limit key size. To illustrate, on the left side is the same curve, but over a small field where we only have integer values negative 128 to 128. When we take it over a finite field, it doesn't look like a smooth curve anymore. However, there are unique properties of elliptic curves that will help us in creating a one-way function to generate public keys from private keys. So as mentioned earlier, Bitcoin's elliptic curve is SECP256K1. This curve is specified with a couple parameters, including the actual curve formula by its coefficients, the field, and a generator point. Note the symmetry of the curve across the x-axis. This symmetry is preserved even when taking it over a finite field. Also note that any non-vertical line in this curve will intersect the curve in at most 3 points. On the graph on the right-hand side, the line through points P and Q intersect at point R. On this elliptic curve, we can do point addition using lines and points. To add P and Q, we simply draw a line through them, intersecting at a third point R, and then reflect the point R across the x-axis, yielding our result P plus Q. And this is called the chord tangent process. This is a trapdoor, or one-way function, because given a point K, that is P plus Q, it is difficult to find the individual points P and Q.